Hello everyone! I thought it would be a good idea to give you guys a summary of the big how to expose Sigma FP RAWs for each of the RAW flavors. Hence, this video contains the highlights of the big one, giving you a bite-sized guide on the good exposure ranges for each ISO. You don't need to have watched the original video. I'll briefly explain the stuff I found relevant, so you know where the values I'm showing you are coming from and what they mean. If you have watched the original CDNG video, make sure you watch the corrections one as well. I've added it in the description below. It's new and fresh and apologetic and explains why I made a couple of changes for some clips compared to the data from the original video. I've already incorporated these changes in here, so if you're new to the series, you don't need to concern yourself with that. Before we dive in though, without going into too much detail, I need to tell you a bit about the noise levels. In the big videos, I've calculated the noise values for the test footage from a selection from the wall next to my subject's face. This produced this table over here. I'm not gonna talk about the values here, but what you need to see is the trend. So basically, the images that contain the noise values in red are not considered good images because they have too much noise. Again, this is wall exposure, not the original exposure. Let's see visually what this means. So here we have a face exposure or an original exposure of 0 EV. So the exposure here is about negative 2 EV, whereas for this bit here, about negative 3 EV. This column tells us what the minimum exposure level should be for the darkest object in the frame in order for the image to look good, not have a lot of noise. For example, for ISO 400, the minimum exposure value for the darkest object in the frame should be negative 1.5. This is the graph corresponding to the table that you just saw, which gives you the exposure values that you can have for each ISO in order for the image not to be clipped and not to have a lot of noise. Now I want to show you the footage that corresponds to the topmost and the bottommost of these values. So for example, for ISO 100, I'm gonna show you the image for plus 2.5 EV and an image that contains an average amount of noise that corresponds to this value. In other words, for the overexposed images, what you're gonna see is the first not clipped image from that particular ISO batch. So for ISO 1600, this is plus 5.5 EV. If we look at the exposure value that's one f-stop higher than that image, we have clipped bits in that image. For the underexposed clips, you'll see the ones with an overall or average acceptable noise level. Since, because of the way I lit this scene, I have a big range between the face exposure and the darkest object.